I have nothing left to bet, you idiot.
The plane.
That's rich.
Oh, why the hell not? I've got you beaten anyway.
Oh, yeah.
What have you got? Hmm? Wipe your mouth, Blackburn.
That wasn't supposed to happen.
But you know, I'll be taking that plane anyway.
What the bloody hell? You lost, I beat you.
The thing is, Rackham, it's a very beautiful aeroplane and you're kind of a jackass.
I beat you fair and square, goddammit. Stay the hell away from my kind. Oh, you bastard. You can't do this to me. I beat you. I beat you.
My name's Clyde Blackburn. I'm a pilot and a gambler.
I'm George Rackham. I'm George bloody Rackham. Listen to me. You bastard, keep off my aeroplane.
If you asked me to name my biggest fault, I'd have to tell you, I'm just not a very honest person.
Welcome aboard. I'm Wilson, by the way. You must be George Rackham.
Sure, I'm Rackham. I'm your guy. Blood, let's get this kite up in the air.
You're George Rackham, son of the 4th Earl of Windsor.
That's right. Hip, 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 hip.
The Bristol was everything it was advertised to be, a pure joy to fly. It was a crisp, sunny day, and everything would have been perfect had I only been alone.
Hey back there! It's a great day for a picnic, don't you think?
Right, you see that plane up ahead? You need to catch up with it!
Yeah, yeah! So listen, I know this little French place, maybe you pick up a couple of girls.
What are you talking about? Girls! This is a test flight! You need to follow the route that plane is setting for you!
Okay, you're the boss, apparently.
Keep up with him or what?
Relax, I've got this.
Then use the throttle and get going. Close the distance.
He's a king.
Let's see how she handles in a gunfight. Guns are unsafe just in case you get some fancy ideas.
You're starting to get me. How sweet. Yeah, I see them.
Try using the rockets on them. Get a feel for hitting the ground targets.
By the time we got the Jerry's beat.
I see.
You're a very suspicious man, Wilson. Has anyone ever told you that?
Jesus Christ! Germans! What do we do?
What do you think? We shoot them down!
We accidentally discovered where Germans were keeping their munitions for half the Western Front. And Wilson's pictures would help HQ launch a major assault. There was just one problem.
I'm not sure about this.
Oh, come on. We did a great thing. We'll get medals for this.
We weren't even supposed to be there.
When the commander sees these pictures, he won't care. We did a great thing. We can do it again.
I'll make you a deal. If we pile up on this, then you need to promise me that you'll get me back in one piece.
Sure thing.
Promise. I need your word.
Okay, I promise.
Stay here. And don't cause any trouble.
You know, I did like the guy. But he was kind of naive.
Sir, you might want to take a look at these.
Saints alive, your man must be one
hell of a pile.
Before we knew it, we were back in the air. Our mission? To clear the way for the bombers so they could blow that fortress all to hell. First, we'd have to down the barrage blimps. Jesus, imagine being a lookout on a blimp. Bad luck, Fritz. Next, we'd have to deal with their anti-aircraft trucks. The assault was already in full swing when we got there. We'd have to deal with all those defenses, then escort our bombers to their target when they arrived. Tall order. But victory here could change the course of the whole damn war, they said. Safe to say, Wilson is less than thrilled.
Now we're actually doing this, it feels really dangerous!
Trust me, and buckle yourself in, baby.
Down those blimps! Clear the way for our bombers!
Easy enough. Watch my back.
Jerry Kite on our tail!
Woo! 4th of July!
All right, don't get carried away!
Got him! 欢迎收看《不止游戏》第五期，我是乔伊。史上没有任何战争能像第一次大战那样为世界带来那么多变化。有人说，在1914年到1918年间，世界从1870年进展到了1940年。这种说法在很多层面上是正确的。士兵们骑着马匹进入了战场，却驾驶着坦克离开，而战斗机的出现更是为人类添加了一种更加高效的互相屠杀手段。毕竟战争推动科技的快速发展，而科技的发展第一时间也服务于战争和国防。1903年12月17日，莱特兄弟发明了第一架飞机，之后各国也掌握了飞机的制造技术，最初用于战场上侦察，偶尔有好事的飞行员用手枪向敌人的阵地和飞机射击，更有甚者掠过阵地时往下扔手榴弹以及向敌机扔砖头。然而这种小打小闹随着战争烈度的不断升级，但荷兰籍设计师安东尼·福克发明出射击断续器，让机枪能够从螺旋桨处射击，也能让飞行员直接透过飞机来瞄准目标。这时真正属于空战机有王牌飞行员的年代才正式到来。在一战爆发之时，各参战国仅有数台飞机可供使用，飞行技巧才诞生不过10年，第一位战斗机驾驶员并没有任何既定的指令可以参考，所以他们不得不边飞行边学习。当时的飞行员训练往往跟战斗中飞行一样危险。到1916年，所有交战国家已经有专业的训练学校，专门训练他们的空军部队在空中如何更快地爬升，或者是做出超过45度空中回旋，变成了标准的训练项目。然而再多的教学也比不上实战经验，当时许多飞行员第一次与敌人交战时就阵亡，因为他们的对手可能有数百小时的实战飞行经验。这种如刀塔对线般滚雪球的方式使得这些飞行员的寿命甚至以小时来计，同时也诞生了不少王牌飞行员。在一战中最具盛名的便是号称红男爵的曼弗雷德·冯·里希特霍芬。1917年是英国皇家空军勃兴的一年，曼弗雷德已成为当时德国空军中的尖子。在成为第11狩猎中队的指挥官后，曼弗雷德将自己的战机一部分涂成了红色，他认为这样可以使地面的友军便于识别，以防误击。此外他特别选择了血红色，也是为了纪念以同一颜色为标志的第一枪骑兵团。他的队员们也争相将自己的飞机涂成了血红色，以示团结一致的精神。在血腥四月中，整个天空都被德军飞机占领。曼弗雷德在29日一天内击落了4架敌机，这是他个人单日的最佳成绩。英国空军在这个月也损失了912名飞行员和侦察员，期间有21架战机算在了曼弗雷德的账上，从此红男爵名震天下。而红男爵驾驶的福克 DR-13E 机，几乎每一位德国飞行员在第一次世界大战中都驾驶过。由于一战相对较窄的三层机翼飞机具有极佳的机动飞行性能，最适宜与敌机进行近距离格斗，所以获得了许多艺高胆大的尖子飞行员的青睐。直到1918年4月21日，红男爵最后一次出击，被一颗从他后方打来的子弹击穿了他的心脏，从胸部飞出。他的死纯粹是运气不好。不管怎样，红男爵再也无法操纵他的爱机，他坠落在科比布雷公路旁边的田野上。事后有很多协约国士兵赶来捡他飞机的红色破片留作纪念，而双方飞行员听到这一消息时不约而同地表示不敢相信红男爵已经阵亡，因为对他们来说这已经成为了一个神话。作为敌人的英国人为红男爵举行了登峰造极的隆重葬礼，德国也为了纪念他而建立了一座全是由战利品拼凑而成的博物馆。战后红男爵的遗体从战区运送回国，这位传奇神话的缔造者，一战空中王牌，在西霍瑞霍夫墓地永远地安息了。他的最终战绩是击落80架敌机，这个在血红战绩里的金发青年，拥有着自信的微笑、骄人的战绩、壮烈的结局，以及他传奇般的一生。